John Malcolm is joining me now. John is the Vice President of the Institute for Constitutional Government and Director of the Meese Center for Legal and Judicial Studies at the Heritage Foundation. John, thanks for joining me.
It's my pleasure. Good to be with you.
John, before we jump into President Trump's executive order that he signed a few hours ago, I want to talk to you about a piece that you co-authored last week with Cully Stimson, Reform of Policing, What Makes Sense and What Doesn't. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, so there are a whole bunch of proposals that are now floating around in light of the horrific killing of George Floyd 3 weeks ago. Everything from greater transparency and accountability, revisiting things like use of force policies and chokeholds, all the way up to completely defunding or dismantling the police department. You know, the nature of the proposals really depend on how bad you see the problem. So there are some people like Antifa, Black Lives Matter movement, who believe that the entire criminal justice system and certainly the policing systems are systemically racist and corrupt and need to be pulled up root and branch and totally reorganized. I don't see it that way. So certainly there are bad cops, to be sure, and poorly trained cops, and there are no doubt some racist cops. There are, you know, racists, unfortunately, in all walks of life. Fortunately, I think that they are a diminishing number. But, you know, the way I look at it, there are approximately 375 million police civilian encounters every year. Last year, according to the Washington Post, 1,003 civilians were killed by police officers. The vast majority of those were in legitimate self-defense. The civilian had a weapon, was attacking the police officer. Out of that, 14 unarmed African Americans were killed by police officers of whatever race. Now that is 14 too many, to be sure, but it does not seem to me to paint a picture of a bunch of white officers with itchy trigger fingers who are going out of their way not to serve and protect the communities that they where they are employed, but to target Black people. There are more African Americans in the police forces than ever before. Professionalism has improved in leaps and bounds over the last few decades, and there are more major police departments headed up by African-American chiefs of police. So there is a problem, and every time an incident like the George Floyd killing happens, you know, like rips a scab off of a wound and rubs salt into it, nobody suffers more from these incidents than the communities where crime is occurring and the police, whose lives are all of a sudden jeopardized, and there develops a lack of trust so the people won't cooperate with them in the communities where they serve. So there's a problem. Certain reform measures may be called for. I think the president took a very positive step in the right direction with his executive order today, but I do not believe that there need to be wholesale revisions, and I certainly do not believe the police forces should be defunded or dismantled.
As I mentioned earlier, President Trump signed that executive order, and I just want to get your reaction to some of the things that he laid out in his executive order moving forward. Creating credentialing and certification programs in every police department across the nation. What's your reaction to this portion of the executive order?
Well, I think developing best practices and credentialing is not a bad idea. It's going to look at things like use of force policies, de-escalation techniques, training, early warning systems for police officers who may be distressed, looking at community engagement practices, and targeting federal funding and training dollars towards people that seek to, or police departments that seek to be accredited. It's not a requirement, but it's certainly an incentive to get people to improve the professionalism of their forces. I think that's a very good idea, along with the other proposals that the president put forward. So, you know, he's asked the Attorney General to develop a system that is going to track adjudicated cases, fully adjudicated cases. So after appeal rights have been exhausted, for police officers who were found to have used excessive force, that way you can't allow bad police officers to sort of leave one law enforcement agency and move on to another without anybody knowing about it. He's going to have you know, develop co-responder programs with social workers. Social workers will respond with them to hopefully de-escalate the situation. And a lot of times, by the way, the people who suffer from these disorders or who are homeless, they're not the perpetrators of crime. They are the victims of crime. I think that a lot of these are really positive steps in the right direction.
And moving forward, do you hope that the Trump administration will do anything beyond more than what was included in this executive order to ensure that, I know part of the executive order was to build that trust up again with law enforcement. Do you see him as the president of the United States doing anything more to help build that trust with law enforcement, especially with communities of color?
Well, so the House Democrats have offered their bill. House Republicans and Senate Republicans are set to release their bill tomorrow or Thursday. We'll have to see what's in it. I'm sure that there are going to be some good proposals, and they've formulated these in cooperation with the White House. I know that one of the things that the president has called on the Attorney General to do is to look at what additional legislation might be needed to do things like have grant programs to support community engagement. That will include dollars for nonprofit organizations within those communities who assist in that effort. So these are all really positive ideas. They're not overly politicized. I think that they take an appropriate scalpel to the issue of police reform rather than a meat cleaver. And hopefully they'll be develop bipartisan support, and police organizations will sign on. There's going to be a look at police union practices and whether there are other changes that can be made to make sure that when bad cops are fired, that they're not then forced to be rehired with back pay usually.
Yes, well, I'm sure this conversation isn't going away anytime soon. And on a positive note, the peaceful protests that came out of George Floyd's death seemed to work. And now we are getting that change and support from President Trump. I know a lot of people were critical of him over the last few weeks and really throughout his entire administration. So hopefully this will be a beacon of hope for not only his administration, but also for the country and specifically communities of color who are, feeling that threat from police officers and law enforcement officers. John Malcolm of the Heritage Foundation, thank you for speaking with me today. I hope you'll join me again in the future.
Absolutely. It would be my pleasure.